This reminds me of my argument with Charlotte this morning. What used to be discussions 2 years ago have turned into duels with yelling, crying, and doors slamming. It's as if there's a playwright in the room, sprinkling every conversation, every decision, every disagreement with a dash of Racinian drama. I'll be glad when this bloody phase has passed. Marceau calls us to order. Where are we at with the computers?
I was just getting to that, Jules replies. We've been tied up with the Montreal apartment and the bloodstained cabin, so Sergeant David's taking care of that. I'd already been through the computer Philippe Caron kept at home with a fine-tooth comb, and all I found was word processing stuff, word documents, all to do with his research, books, classes, or articles he was writing for university publications or magazines. His online history only shows weekly connections to his inbox. Looks like he only checked and replied to his personal emails on weekends. That means no browsing tracks for any basic auction or murderabilia sites. I didn't even find any trace of him accessing porn sites, and that's saying something. He must still be doing the DVD thing. Still, Sergeant David came in behind me and gave things a good seeing to, if you'll pardon the expression.
Jules touches a finger to his nose and clears his throat, delighting for a moment in the pleasure of his innuendo. I note Gina's amused smile as she helps herself to another donut, and Marceau's total lack of reaction as she waits for what's next, arms folded to a white silk blouse ironed to perfection.
David didn't find anything either. Same with Philippe Caron's work computer. He only really went online to get into his work inbox, which was merged with his personal email, as it happens. A few hits on the university web portal, but nothing else. Other than that, just Word documents, the same as those on his personal computer,